Hello friend, welcome back to Network Labroom channel. To continue Citrix NetScaler Lab series, today I would like to cover step to set up the SSL Outloading configuration. Basically, SSL Outloading helps the web server to process traffic based on the encryption or decryption traffic sent via the SSL protocol. There are two types to deploy the SSL Outloading. One is the termination and bridging. SSL offloading termination connection between the log balancing server and web server is non-encrypted. And SSL offloading bridging connection between the log balancing server and web server is encrypted. Come back to the MyWZ. Today I add one more to open SSL server. I still had the Citrix 1 and Citrix 2 connect to Sys 1 and Sys 2. I had the web 1 and web 3 into group 1. I had the firewall connect to internet, and I opened the remote user 1 to testing the SSL connection. The first hop on, I need create SSL outloading, and after that I will add my certificate to the Citrix NetScaler, and today I will config the SSL outloading termination. It means connection between the Citrix log balancer and web server is non-encrypted. My web server 1 and 3 still use HTTP. Okay, now let me open the terminal of Linux server and create SSL certificate using the open SSL. The first of all, I need to create a private key, and then I will create a root CA, and third I will create a CSR certificate signing request, and finally I will use a private key, root CA, and CSR to create my local SSL certificate. I using the open SSL. Okay, open SSL. Sorry, a chain SA and out and private key name of private key and 204A. Okay, then I need to create a root CA using the private key. Using open SSL also, and request S509 renew root CA new node, and input a key, my private key, and encryption. Valid days 100 day, and out the name of proceed.pem, and now I will define some parameter, country name and locality name, origin name, network labroom, origination unit name, so network lab room, common name network lab room, local, and email address I will ignore, and then let me show. Okay, I had the variable key, I had the rosa.pem, and next, I need to create a certificate signing request. So using the open RSL, request new and input a key, private key, and out the CSR dot CSR. Okay, so next work problem and next work problem and common name. Okay, next work problem logo and ignore the email address and challenge backward. I will ignore. Okay, let me guess CSR. Okay, request, certificate request, and finally, I need to create a LL certificate using private key, RCA, and CSR. It means I will signing the CSR using private key and RCA. It means I sign the CSR by my using the my private key and RCA. Okay, using open SSL @509 request days 100 days input is CSR and CIA RCA PM and CI key my private key and output a SSL CRT encryption 256 and okay. Let me list file and get the SSL dot CSR. Okay. Okay. Now let me go to the Citrix GUI and input the my SSL certificate. Let me open the. Okay. To input the certificate, you need to go to the traffic management and SSL certificates and on certificates and then install the certificate using the certificate file name and key file name. Okay, let me naming for my certificate. Let me test and join file. So I need to copy this one in file and then input C and create new files. SSL dot CRT. Yes. Okay, and edit with notepad. Okay, and save it. And one more, I need to create the private key. Okay, yes, and he did not pass, so and open the cache private key and then copy this one Okay, and open. Okay. Okay, and size. Okay. Okay, now I have two files, private key and SSL certificate. Now I will go to the GUI, this one, and add. Let me add this one. Sorry. Local. And go to the my. Okay. This one and bus, this one and air certificate and private key, this one. Case no bug works and using notify when it's by installed. Okay, I done install the my local SSL certificate, and the next step I need go to the load balancer and create one the SSL service to server. Let me add one SSL VIP and protocol is SSL and address 10 of 10 101 and 1 2 3 and okay. Okay, and now let me binding the service. Okay, I will choose service web 1 and service web 3. You see protocol still is HTTP, not HTTPS, because I'm using the SSL termination. And binding and continue. And I need to binding the my SSL certificate to the load balancing V2 server. Choose it and browse to the server certificate and choose test certificate I create the previous and select and binding and then continue. In this one, you had a lot of advanced settings, but I will not mention today. So I will done. Okay, you see the SSL V2 IP up. The SSL will up if the service binding to the SSL V2 server and had the certificate binding also. This mandatory condition to make the SSL V2 server up. Okay. So I'm done config the SSL V2 server and also the SSL adopting termination. So that is very easy, right? And in the firewall, I had the policy of to forward the V2 IP to the SSL V2 server in the Citrix load balancing already. Let me show the configuration. Okay, so policy, firewall policy, and this one I had the TCP forwarding box 80 and web V2 IP box 443. Okay, now let me go to the remote user 01 and access the HTTPS using the V2 IP 115.1.1.3. Okay, this one. Sorry, let me start again. Okay, the logging user one. Open the web browser. Okay, and this one 115 .1.1.3 HTTP. You see warning the security risk ahead. Because my certificate is local, so the web browser told me the it don't trust this HTML. Accept and set the trick and continue. Okay, it's web 0, and let me refresh web 3, web 1, and web 3. Okay, let's check the SSL certificate information, more information, and view a certificate. You see the country, state, locality, organization, a common name, issue name, and the validity 100 day. This means over the 3 months. Okay, and the public info using ASSA and KIZAI 2048. Okay, fingerprints using the 256. Okay, but what happened if I access the HTTP? Let me delete the HTTPS and access. You see, I cannot access the HTTPS if I only type the HTTP in the web browser. Because in the NetScaler load balancer, I have still not config the redirection box IT yet, so my web browser cannot redirect the HTTP to HTTPS. Let me come back to the SSL virtual IP and config the redirection filter. Go to the basic setting and click the more, and then this one redirect from box IT and HTTPS the redirect URL. HTTPS 115.1.1.3. You need to type the full domain you in your production. Okay, and then continue, and okay, continue one more time, and done. Okay, let's check again. Let me open the new pop and type HTTP 115.1.1.3 and in. You see, my web browser redirect the HTTP to HTTPS. Okay, let's check the certificates. View the certificates. Same information, right? Okay, let's check using the private browser. HTTP 115.1.1.3. Okay, still redirect to the HTTPS. Okay, more information and view the certificate. Okay, same. Okay. So now let's check what happened in the packet when redirect or when user access the HTTP or HTTPS. I will using the Architecture feature on the firewall, and I will remove the HTTPS forwarding, and then check whether I can capture the content of user when I set my web server using HTTP or not. Okay. Okay, let's go to the network and the bucket capture. I set up one the bucket capture array, GFTLS, and create new. This one interface box 2 and the maximum capture bucket. Okay, it's a default. And I go to the policy. This one I will edit. I will delete the HTTP 442 reach HTTPS and keep the 80. Okay. And I will modify the virtual IP to the 1. Let me check. Okay. 101 and 101. Okay. And I will start the bucket capture and go to the web server and delete the HTTPS. Okay, let me open HTTP 105.1.1.3. Okay. Happen. Sorry, I've need delete this box redirection. Okay. Continue one more time and done. Okay, go to HTTP 115.1.1.3. Okay. .1.1.3. Okay, no skill. Okay, let me go to the emails. Sorry, I will go to the bucket capture and stop and then restart. Okay, refresh. Okay, since it's a mess, and open the file, this one. Okay, this is the content of file, and wait a second for firewall collect all information, and stop. I will download and open the file by WISAC. Okay, and let me find out the IP 114. Sorry, my 114.1.1.2. Okay, and find out the HTTP. Yes, this one. Get HTTP and find out the content. This one web 03 and The UCs is my web HTTP and the content maybe this one. You see, let me open resize the window. You see it's content land 34 and content a hello friend, how are you? Okay, so the HTTP not skill the content of user. Now let me enable the HTTL loading again and then check the whether the HTTL loading encrypts the user content or not. I will close the WhatsApp and stop this one. Let me stop. Stop. Okay. Go to the system. V2IB and modify this one to read. Okay. And the firewall policy and it's at 443 detonation. Yes, this one. Okay. Okay. And come back to next scalar chase UI and modify the SLV to IB. And it's enable the relation block. This one. And IT and URL is https://115.1.1.3. Okay. And continue. Continue and done. Say configuration. Okay. Firewall, I need to open the bucket capture one more time and restart. Okay. But stop, stop. Okay, I will modify something. I will filter the IB 114.1.1.2 block 80443. Okay, and let me open this one. This one. Okay, and start and up. You see, reaction is working fine. And okay, let me assess its match and assess the web 01.txt. Okay. Okay, because I have a two web firewall a web server one, but in web server 3 I don't have the file. So you see the error. Okay, it doesn't matter now, right? Okay, now let me stop the capture and download my file, this one, and check what happened. You see now the connection is TSL version 1.2. It means the connection between user and my web server is encrypted. Okay, let me check. TP SYN server hello certificates and client exchange. Let me check the okay. Let me use in the web browser. Not private window and hope to see the more information. Let me redact this one and asset open the new
new window 1.5. Okay, and a set, let me set the image and set the web. Okay, and wait a second for firewall collect on the bucket between user and web, my web server. Okay, stop and download this file and open by Wysock. Okay, you see this vsync arc and get HTTP, but the HTTP had the object moving the code A 302, and it means the my reaction working to chain box 82443, and after that you see this is established again using arc and arc. Okay, and then HTTP is established and TTL protocol show here, and when I access the ismet folder, the TCP will start again. You see, yes, it's my HTTP, but the my CDNS killer will send the object move to HTTPS one more time, the same with the user content. Now you cannot see any content of user here because the TSL encrypted content. Let me check. Okay, only encrypted, right? Okay, I think the SSL overloading on CDNS killer, my configuration on working file are using the SSL overloading termination. I think sometimes you worry about the how create SSL certificate, but in your production you just contact the vendor and they will send you on file on information you need. I create the SSL certificate because in the lab I don't have the public SSL certificate. Okay, I should stop video here, and thank you for watching, and see you in next video. I hope getting your like and your subscribe, my friend. Bye bye.